One of my favorite treats to bring is lemon poppy seed cake, which is what I'm making now. And I make it in this bun pan. Okay, that's the pan. Now the batter. So I started with 2 sticks of butter, it's 1/2 pound, and 2 cups of granulated sugar. Butter has to be room temperature so it really gets light and fluffy. And I've mixed it for about 2 or 3 minutes, and it's just about done. So, next is eggs. I've got 4 room temperature eggs, and I do it 1 egg at a time. 1 teaspoon of good vanilla. And 1/3 cup of lemon zest. It's a lot, but it is lemon poppy seed cake after all. Okay, now I'm ready for the wet ingredients and the dry ingredients, and I'll show you how I combine them. I started on the wet mix a couple of hours ago. I poured 1 cup of buttermilk into a liquid measuring cup, added 1/3 cup of poppy seeds, and stirred them together. I set the mixture aside for 2 hours to allow the poppy seeds to soften. Then when the time was up, I added 1/4 cup of freshly squeezed lemon juice and mixed it in. For the dry mix, I measured out 2 3/4 cups of all-purpose flour and put it into a sieve set over a bowl. Then added 1/4 cup of cornstarch, 1 teaspoon of kosher salt, 1/2 teaspoon of baking powder, 1/2 teaspoon of baking soda, and sifted them all together. So at this point, I'm gonna turn down the mixer to its lowest stir. And starting with the dry ingredients, I'm just gonna slowly add them in thirds. First the dry ingredients, then the wet ingredients. And just let it mix in until it's just done. Don't wanna overmix once the flour's in. And then I always turn it off and actually use the spatula to just fold it in and make sure it's really well mixed. Okay, that's perfectly mixed. So now into the bun pan. This cake's great because you can make it, you can keep it in the refrigerator. I always serve it at room temperature, but it'll hold in the refrigerator for about 1 week. Or you can freeze it really well. And just take your spatula and smooth the top. Make sure it's even. Okay, into the oven, 350 degrees for 45 minutes till a toothpick comes out clean. Okay, how good does that look? Okay, I'm gonna let this sit for about 10 minutes. If you turn out a hot cake, sometimes it can break and you don't wanna do it. No point in going through all that trouble. So in the meantime, I'm gonna make lemon drizzle to pour over the cake. I've got 1/2 cup of fresh lemon juice and 1/2 cup of sugar, granulated sugar. I'm just gonna cook it just enough so that the sugar dissolves. Okay, this is done. I'm just gonna turn it off. So the cake is cooled for about 10 minutes. You can actually see it just pulls away from the pan a little bit. So normally you just dump it out like that, but I always worry about it breaking. Don't want a broken cake. So I'm gonna take the rack and just turn it over like that. And if you're lucky, and if you grease the pan properly, it'll come out. And there it is. That looks great. So now I'm gonna take the drizzle to pour over the cake. And you don't wanna dump it on it. You just wanna sort of slowly run it around so that it absorbs it, just like that. And I did it over a baking pan so that it didn't run all over the kitchen. It just runs into the pan. Because too much is never enough, I'm gonna make a glaze to put on the cake. So I need 1 cup of confectioner sugar and 1 few tablespoons of fresh lemon juice. Maybe about 1.5, but I'm gonna do it slowly. I'm looking for something that's like a very thick but pourable glaze. Let it just run down the sides, just like that.